What's up, guys? It's your girl Deja D, and today I'm here with a Hampton Q&A. A lot of incoming freshmen have been DMing me, telling me they love my dorm tour series, they loved all my vlogs. But a lot of people have been DMing me saying thank you for the dorm tour, asking me so many questions. How did you like living in dorm? How's Hampton's social life? How this? How that? How that? And I love, love, love answering everybody's questions just because I wanted that when I was coming to Hampton. So I decided to do a whole video on it. Had you guys send me the questions. A lot of Hampton 24 has been following me. Hey y'all, what's up? But before we get into this video, be sure to subscribe if you're not. Right now I'm at 777 subscribers after this video. I know you all are watching, so be sure to subscribe. It is free, it is good content. The admissions office don't offer stuff like this, so tag Hampton, have them cut me a check for recruiting everybody, okay? Recruiting everybody. So we are at 777 subscribers. Let's just get to 800. Let's get to over 800 from this video, okay? Like this video. I know y'all are watching. Do not DM me unless you comment under this video. Comment HU, ogre, I don't know y'all number, but ogre, comment onyx if you're onyx. Shoot, this video is going to be up there, so the next upcoming onyx class, the next upcoming quintessence, the next upcoming ogres, and for years to come, comment your class, comment your year, comment what school you are, comment what state you're coming from. I want to see these comment sections go as live as my DM inboxes are going, okay? So if you got any more questions, drop them here. Every single person who DM'd me, every single person who liked it, every single person who asked the question that got answered in this video, I want to see a comment. I know y'all putting me in y'all group chats. I know y'all are watching. I want to see a comment from every single person. Every single view should have a comment. Every single view should have a like, okay? That's what I'm betting y'all. I'm not doing a part two unless this one do numbers, okay? I'm going to do numbers. I'm not doing part two until this one get numbers. And I say what I said, I meant what I said. So let's just hop into these questions. I'm going to be very, very honest in this video because I think I owe that to y'all. I think if you're going to spend $40,000, over $40,000 on a school a year, you deserve honesty. And also, disclaimer, all of these are my personal opinions. I may have had a better time, or I may have had a worse experience compared to other people, so these are just my opinion. This is not my first Hampton video, so I have a dorm tour series. I put Twitchell, VC Hall, the suites. I had so much more, but coronavirus wants to kick us off campus. So when I go back up there to pack up all my stuff, I'm gonna do my dorm tour really quick. Nothing as deep and detailed as I wanted to, but I'm gonna do my own dorm tour because a lot of you all, if you do not know, I have a double by myself. And we'll talk more about that later on.
So the first question, things incoming freshmen should know before they get on campus.
Okay, so I'm not sure if you all know this, but incoming freshmen, you do have a curfew the first half of the first semester. Depending on the behavior, you're supposed, come on, this ain't Tiger King. Okay, but depending on the behavior is whether or not you get off. We got off in the middle of homecoming week. So yeah, hopefully your class is good, but you will have curfew. And on curfew is Sunday through Thursday, it is 11 p.m. You have to be in your dorm room. And then Friday and Saturday is 1 a.m. But once we were off curfew, you realize how much a burn it curfew was on. Like, even if you're not at a party, it's just like, you know, you could go out late night Waffle House runs, or like just anything. You could be in the library, you go sit outside longer. Like, you just realize how curfew was just so unnecessary, but it wasn't too bad, and you're not on it that long. So, and another thing you should know is you do not have visitation. We were getting off visitation the week that that coronavirus hit and we had got home. So we didn't get our visitation until like the end of February, beginning of March. So don't expect no little boys or no little girls to be up in your room, because they ain't gonna be up in your room. Y'all gonna find somewhere else to do that. Y'all go find somewhere else to do that. So
yeah, you ain't gonna have none of that unless you sneak them in, but I don't recommend that because you will get kicked off. So if you're gonna let curfew and visitation stop you from going to a really good school, you need to rethink your priorities, okay? What dorm did I stay in and did I like it? Okay, so I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I stayed in the dorm that I wanted to stay in. When I came to admitted students day, I only seen two dorms, and that was Kelsey and Twitchell, and I did not want to stay in Kelsey. It was nothing wrong with the dorm. I just did not want to stay in there. It's no elevator in Kelsey. Be sure to check out my dorm tour series. I have Kelsey, and I show you all the kitchen. I show you all everything. I show you the dorm, the bathroom, everything. So go run the numbers up on there too. If you're staying in Kelsey, I want to see you put a comment under that video. If you're staying in Twitchell, put a comment under my Twitchell dorm series. And if you're staying in the suites, put a comment under there. And yeah, I don't have Kennedy or... I think that was it. And Moton is from my pre-college vlog. So if you stayed in Moton, when I went to pre-college, I did my dorm tour for that. So I stayed in Twitchell and I was very happy about that. Did I like it? It was pros and cons, but it was pros and cons with a lot of dorms. Twitchell's the only dorm other than Moton that had an elevator. Yeah, because Kelsey does not have an elevator. VC Hall, oh my god, I would have cried if I stayed in there. If you're staying in VC Hall, there's no elevator. So, and you got to take like a flight of stairs to get to the first floor. More details on that is on my VC Hall dorm tour. So yeah, I'm not all of the dorm related videos, dorm related questions, if they are something like more specific, I just say go check out my dorm tour series. I tell you everything, show you the bathrooms, everything. So yeah, I stayed in Twitchell. It was pros and cons. Like, a pro would be that it's very new. Our dorms was really nice. We had an elevator. It was a nice dorm. However, Twitchell has a lot of females in it. So I think it's like over 300 girls in there. And it felt like it was just always something going on. Like, I'm not going to expose the business that was going in there, but it was just always something. Like, if it wasn't something in the bathroom, it was something in the lobby. If it wasn't something in the lobby, it was somebody fighting in their dorm rooms. If it wasn't somebody fighting in their dorm rooms, it was people just being loud. If it was people not being loud, it was just girls missing curfew. It was just always something. So, pros would be that really clean dorm, really nice rooms, air conditioned. Like, it was good. It was nice looking, pretty. But cons would just be, it's just so much going on. And I didn't live in no other dorm to tell you if it was stuff going on in there. But my experience in Switzerland was just... Please, just shut up. Get the group me quiet. Y'all doing too much. Next question is, how is the food in the cafeteria? Honestly, I'm a chicken and salad kind of girl. Like, I love, if y'all watch my mukbang shoot, I had a chicken salad the other day. But I'm a chicken and salad kind of girl. Like, I never really ate the sides unless it was like fried chicken Wednesday and I would get like mac and cheese and collard greens. I don't really like the sides at the school. And that's just because I felt like they weren't seasoned all the way. Like, they would have vegetables there, but it would just look like they just steamed it or just cooked it. No salt, no pepper, which I guess might be an allergy reason, but I would just get a salad and a piece of chicken, or a salad and whatever meat they had. Don't do it. A salad and whatever meat they had, or like if they had ribs and ribs in the salad. So honestly, it wasn't that bad to me. I like salads, so I would make a salad like every single day. And every day we had rotisserie chicken. They would either put barbecue on it, teriyaki sauce, like whatever. So I was okay with it. Some days I was over it, but I love to save money. So the calf is free. Well, it's not free because you pay for it, but it's already paid for. So I would like stick it up. Yo, I don't want to hear that. You need a channel if you want to make all this noise. But yeah, overall, the food in the calf was not like, on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to just give it like a 6. Some days is better than others, and then some weeks I just did not know what they were doing. Like, some weeks I felt like they were just coming to work and just cutting on the oven, and whatever was already, like, whatever they seen, they just cooked it. Some days you go on a cafe and it's just like, yo, what did y'all cook? Like, nothing in here looks good. Nothing in here looks appetizing. They would put like dumb stuff on the pieces sometimes. Like, the pizza wouldn't even just be regular pepperoni and cheese pieces. Sometimes they would just put like
kale, and I would have thought it was spinach. I'm okay with eating spinach on a pizza, but kale, like, it would just be stuff that's like, why would you put this on your, like, carrots? Who told you to put carrots on a pizza? So yeah, I'm gonna get a cast like a 5 through 7. 5 through 7, 7 on a good day. Is the dress code strict? No, the dress code is not strict. It's mostly based off of your teacher. My pre-college year, when I was in pre-college, it wasn't really my first semester. No, the dress code wasn't strict. I didn't have no teachers like take off your hat, anything like that. It was mainly my second semester. My math teacher, he was the one who was really enforcing it, like no hats in class, stuff like that. But all my other classes was pretty chill. I'm trying to think. Oh, it was one time in the calf, like the calf start trying to enforce the dress code, and I was mad because my hair, like, okay, y'all might see me all glammed up on here or whatever, but if you catch me on campus, like, on a regular day, I'm just like here, present, just alive, getting through, struggling. College is hard, and I was really on my stuff this semester, so I was not worrying about getting dressed all the time. So I would just come straight out the dorm and just go to eat and then go back into the dorm. And the cafeteria ladies, they one time was like, you need to take your hat off. And I was like, my hat? Like, why I gotta take my hat off? And yeah, it was just a lot. I ended up leaving out the calf that night. It was because my hair was not done. Like, before my hair got this length, when I first started growing it out, it was like a dumb, ugly length. And it was just not cute. And I couldn't wear my do-rag in there. I couldn't wear my hat. They told me I couldn't wear a turban one time. I had tied a turban on my head. They were just doing a lot. So I just left out that night. I was like, forget y'all. So yeah, the dress code, it depends on your teacher. So some teachers are real chill. Like, I had classes where I would wear red hat and everything like that. I'm not the type of person to wear no wild looking stuff to class anyways. Like, I would not go to class in no booty shorts and a little crop top up here anyways, just because, for what? I don't need my teacher seeing me like that. So I never had no experience like that, just because I know how to conduct myself. Like, catch me at 12-2, catch me at Harlem or something like that one. But yeah, when I'm going to class, I'm not wearing nothing wild. 12-2, they will enforce the dress code. Like, as far as, like, I seen one time this girl had this lingerie little bodysuit on and some jeans at 12-2, and they told her she need to cover that up. But it was another girl who had it on and they was fine with it, so I don't know. I think it just depends. Main thing at 12-2 they be worried about is if you got a hat on. I think the biggest thing is just wearing hats. So yeah, and of course, just don't go looking like all your little real raunchy outfits. Save that for like parties off campus, parties in the Harbs. Save those for like outside parties. Like, I don't know about Holland. Maybe Holland. You could probably wear them in Holland. But like 12-2, stuff like that. Save those type of parties. I mean, those outfits to like the block parties in the Harbs. You know, stuff off campus, offline, like offline. This one again is about if I stayed in Twitchell, and if so, what are the big rooms? So I did stay in Twitchell. The big rooms will be the rooms closest to the elevator. So my friend, she lived in a corner room, and I think her room number was like, I'm not going to say like what floor, but it was something 03. So it could have been 103, 203, 303, whatever. I think it was 03. Yeah, whatever room is closest to the elevator on the left side. So the side with the RAs, so it's the RA's room, and then there's the big room. The big corner room is like way bigger than the other room. It's probably like 2.5. So it's like, let's say one, it's probably like double the size of a regular room. I don't know why, but yeah, the corner rooms and the inside, those are the big rooms. They are so freaking big. Like, so freaking big. So if you got like 203 or 303 or something like that, yeah, you probably got the big room. I don't know if it was 203 or 205, but yeah, them rooms big as I don't know what. Is there anything specific we have to bring move-in day? Okay, so I could do a separate video on like what to bring, like dorm stuff. So that's why, like, y'all have to show love on this video if you want part two. So I'm gonna get in details with that, because I feel like that's a whole separate video in its own, like a a dorm checklist. But one thing they didn't like that I wasn't informed of until I got there is moving day. You have to, you already pay for your room and board, but they're going to give you your class fees. My class fee was $60. So that include like my freshman ball ticket. That include like, you know, your class t-shirt. That include a lot of different things. So they're going to offer, you don't have to pay that day. But there's also dorm fees, like dorm dues. So our dorm dues was like, I don't know, I can't think. It was like $30 maybe, $40. I'm not 100% sure off the top of my head. But they did give us, like when we were checking and getting our keys or whatever, we did have to pay our dorm dues first. Dorm dues is the main thing you have to worry about. The class dues, you could play those later on. I paid mine the day of, so I just paid all of that stuff the same day I got there. But I didn't know we needed to do that, so I had to go to the ATM before I got my key. How to stay out of drama. Okay, so one thing I say about how to stay out of drama, okay, I'm not saying you gotta be like a little punk and not speak your opinion, but just pick and choose your battles. Like, for example, last week on Twitter, they were doing too much. Shoot, yesterday on Twitter, they was doing too much. I know y'all know what I'm talking about, that video. Just mind your business. Like, it's okay. Like, talk your trash in your group chat with your friends. And I ain't saying talk about the girls or talk about the people. But just pick your battles. Don't go under the people comments talking all crazy. Just mind your business. Like, if you wasn't in the video, if your boyfriend ain't in the video, and unless you putting laughing emojis or LOL or whatever, don't put your opinion on the internet. We do not care that much. All you're gonna do is start drama. All you're gonna do is that. And if you are not ready to bite the bullet, like, and if you, let's say for the example, those girls, I'm not in here to speak no trash. I'm not saying nothing. Do what you do. But if you're gonna post stuff like that, just be prepared for whatever consequences come with it. If people call you out your name, if somebody girlfriend is on there, somebody boyfriend on there, if the dudes want to talk trash, just if you want to post something, be prepared for the repercussions that's going to come along with it. So them girls, if they don't care, let them do what they want to do. That is their business. Like, it is not your place to be telling people what's right and wrong. They got mothers and fathers. They is old enough to know what is right and wrong. They know what they doing. Mind your business. Okay, so to stay out of drama, just don't say or do anything. Don't post anything that you cannot back up. Last week, Hampton was doing a lot on Twitter as far as an organization having their week or whatever. I may have my own opinions, good or bad. If I ain't trying to get into nothing, that is not my business. If you don't want to join that club, don't join the club. If you don't want to go to an event at school, don't go to the event. Just mind your business. I think that's the main thing. How to say the drama, just mind your business, you know? Mind your business and you will be okay. Also, there's a lot of different states and people do things differently in different states. So I'm from PG County. I no longer say the city that I live in anymore just out of safety reasons, but I live in Maryland. I'm from PG County. And the way that we do things in PG County may be different than the way that they do things in Atlanta. The way that they do things in Atlanta may be different than the way they do things in Jersey, so on and so forth. So people grow up differently. People's backgrounds are different. Even people from PG County that went to different schools than me, whose parents are different than mine, we all grew up with different things. And that's just one of the parts about going away for college. You just meet so many different cultures and it is a learning opportunity. Don't call anybody weird. Don't say what somebody's doing is wrong because they may feel like what you're doing is wrong. I know for me, for example, lately a lot of people from my school have just been calling me out of the blue. And when I say calling me, I mean like FaceTime, phone call, like, I don't know, but the way I do stuff, you text before you call somebody, and then you don't call people that you don't talk to that often, or you don't know or talk to, like, even my friends from school, we don't just be calling each other, like, randomly, and I don't know if that's just me, but I could easily call somebody weird for that, or whatever. So, long story short, don't call people weird, because they might think you weird. Who are you to say what's weird or not? Just mind your business. I don't want to say stay to yourself, but every single thing that comes to your head do not need to be spoken out loud. Pick your battles and Yeah, I just, mainly the main reason why drama occurs is when people do not mind their business. Like, mind the business that pays and keep you. You are not Wendy Williams. You are not the Shade Room. You are none of these people. So you ain't getting paid for your opinions. Therefore, you just need to keep them. You wait till you get paid for that. And fighting will get you kicked out of school. So if you ain't gonna fight, it's no need to talk. If you don't like somebody, you just don't gotta talk to them. You still can respect them, you know, be respectful. You ain't gotta be all nasty. Shoot, even if you won't, if you decide to walk past that person and never look at them, like, you could not like somebody and just look past them. You can't fight them. If you fight them, you going home. So I don't know. I don't like doing a lot of talking. If I don't like you, we either not gonna talk or we gonna fight. And I ain't gonna fight because I'm not getting kicked out of school for you. So just shut up. If you don't like somebody, just shut up. That's how you stay out of drama. You can't fight, so shut up. No need. What is my favorite thing about Hampton? I like how Hampton is a very family camp. Like, it's easy to know a lot of people there. And when I say no, I'm not talking about like, oh, buddy, buddy friends. But everybody's so like kind of friendly in a way. As long as you're not like drama or known as like have a bad reputation or whatever, it's pretty chill. It's like a hey, hi, what's up environment. Everybody's kind of real open. I love the people there. I haven't had like a super bad experience. I had like a few little things going on, but as far as like horrible, no. I met some of my really good friends there, had some of the best times there, best experiences. I've learned a lot. But one of my favorite things about it is like it's real easy to get to meet a lot of people. It's a big enough campus for you to not feel like, oh, I see the same people every day, but small enough for it to be family like, you know. That's what I like about it. Are the parties lit? So yeah, that answers the question. Was it easy making friends? So for my pre-college experience, no, it was not easy. I had like, you know, kind of ups and downs there that I'm not really going to go into detail about. But yeah, long story short, pre-college was a little difficult for me, just transitioning. But my fall semester, I met some of my friends, hot in the paint, here y'all go, period. I met a really good friend. I have a really good friend group to this day. And yeah, once you meet those group of people, I say just one of my main things about, one of my main tips and advice as far as meeting people is to just be open. Do not close yourself in. Don't click up too easy. But one thing I would say is, these people that you're meeting and these people that you are becoming friends with, everybody cannot go into your bedroom. Everybody cannot go into your personal space. And the reason I mean like your bedroom is as far as we live on campus. So you may, I have friends there that I'm cool with. Like, we could meet up in the stew. We could meet up in Holland. We could meet up in the calf or whatever. But I also have those friends where these are the girls that I'm willing to cash up money to take an Uber with, like trustworthy people, people I'm really cool with. When it's time to go to a party, we walk in there together. I can count on y'all to walk there with me. We walk back together. You know, we got each other. And also, everybody cannot come into your room. And when I say your room, your dorm room, people, everybody, everybody I talk to cannot come up in my room. I don't know y'all, my stuff is up in here. So yeah, we just gonna be mindful with that. So that's when I say, like, don't click up, but also have that group of people that y'all can come in my room. Just think about it like this. These are my friends for the stew. These are my friends for the dorm. So yeah, definitely once I met my good group of friends, it was really easy, social, love it every single time I'm with them. Rank each freshman dorm from best to worst. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with y'all now. I'm gonna be real honest. EC Suites is nice. And I'm not hating in no form or fashion. I wanted to be in there at first, but I'm kind of glad that I was not in there, just because it's probably like, I don't know how many, I'm not going to say the exact number, it's less than 100 people that live in there. So it's very, very small, and the rooms are big. So your room is really big. Your room is probably like the size of my I don't know. Your rooms are big. The rooms are really big and nice. However, I feel like it's not really dormy. So you have your bathroom in your room. So you don't have no reason to go talk to the girls. Like, you don't have a reason to see the girls down the hall. I don't live in there. Never lived in there. So, you know, it may have been different. But you don't have a reason to go down the hall to the bathroom to the other girls. There's no common place for people to meet up. So I feel like it's probably a lot harder to socialize. So I ain't gonna talk too much because I ain't never lived in there. But VC Suites, as far as rooming situation, is nice because, I mean, you don't have to worry about no bathroom problems unless your roommate is wild. But you don't really gotta worry about no bathroom problems. It's just your room. You have everything in your room, and your room is really nice, really big. So VC Suites can go. I'm gonna put, that's not even like considered a dorm. It's a suite. So whatever. But as far as dorms, okay. Okay, so Moulton, I lived in Moulton for pre-college. I'm gonna put Moulton at the bottom though. Moulton is set up just like Twitchell. It has an elevator. But Moulton had a roach problem. I never had a roach in my room because your girl is clean. But a lot of people have roaches in their room. It was a roach problem. So I'm gonna put Moulton at the bottom because anything more roaches and mice, like an issue like that, need to go at the bottom. And they said it was because that one is the closest to the water, but I don't want to hear it. Y'all could throw a bomb up in it. Push the building back. Shouldn't have had no roaches in there like that. So Moulton is at the bottom. And then I'm gonna say VC Hall because that's too many stairs. Like, you gotta take a whole flight of stairs to get to the first floor. What we doing moving day? So VC Hall was very old. I did not like that dorm. So VC Hall next. And it's confusing in there. It's like, it's not a straight hall. It's just like this. VC Hall. So Moulton, VC Hall. If Moulton ain't had roaches, then it would be VC Hall at the bottom for me. But I'm put Moulton, VC Hall, Kelsey, Twitchell. Kennedy not on the list. Never been in there. But I'm gonna just throw Kennedy right on top of Moulton. So it's Moulton, Kennedy, VC Hall, Kelsey, Twitchell. Twitchell's the best one. Honestly, although we be having drama and stuff going on, it's the best looking dorm if we talking about looks. Do I see myself graduating from Hampton? Yes. During pre-college, if my fall semester would have been like my pre-college semester was socially, probably would have left. But it's a lot of questions, y'all. So I'ma just end the video off with this last question. That I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna do a part two. Like I said, do numbers on this one, and I'm gonna be sure to get to part two. So how do you pick a roommate? So when you get your housing application, you get to pick two dorms, your top one and your second choice. And then it asks you at the bottom of it, do you have a roommate that you would like to do, or do you want to do a random roommate? So if you have a roommate you would like to do, you and this person have to both put your name on the line. Like, you put your name, I mean, you put her name or his name, you put that person's name, and then they on their application have to do the same thing. They have to put your name. If y'all both don't do it, it ain't gonna work. So y'all both have to put each other's name, and yeah, you have to put each other's name. And then if you want a random roommate, then they select it for you and they send it to you. I selected a random roommate and then I never got assigned anyone. So that's how I got my own room. And that's gonna be the last question that I'm gonna do for today because I felt like I answered a lot and got kind of in detail. So be sure to check out all my Hampton content. Like I said, do numbers on this one. Be sure to subscribe. I want this video to get over 800 subscribers. So without further ado, I love you all so, so much. And welcome to the Hampton family. Bye.